Decker Sports Agency, please hold. Decker Sports Agency.
Demo, good job in New York. Sign him and dine him, baby. Stevie, give me a sec. Head to my office now.
Hey, Rob.
Not now, Mike. How's Boston deal?
Close it.
Yes. Love it. Money in the bank.
Good morning, Rob.
Good morning, Mr. Becker.
Peter, hook it up in a few?
You got it, buddy.
Beautiful. Stevie. No. I did not say that. No, I would never say that. Of course, I'll run it by him. I'm his agent. That's my job. Well, if we don't talk tonight, I'm sure you'll wake me up tomorrow with your real offer. Yeah, that's funny. What?
Schedule. You have a 9 a.m. conference call, lunch downstairs, and your mother called. You do remember your mother, don't you?
Hold on.
Do you want to call her back?
Not now.
How old is your mother, Rob?
Ooh, 75, 76, I think.
Well, then, by all means, take your time getting back to her.
Claire, time is money. Mom ain't making us money today. Next. Talk faster.
You have a haircut.
Ooh, 1/8 of an inch. When?
45 minutes ago. But your midnight text told me that you wanted to see Peter first thing this morning.
I do. I actually just saw Peter in the hallway. He should be walking in right about now. Peter!
Yeah?
How are the kids?
Well, they're great, thanks.
Ask me how my kids are. My clients are my kids. Only better, they make me money. This is the next Decker Sports superstar.
Sean Hart?
Mm-hmm.
I don't think he's going pro.
Why not? Why not, Peter?
Well, he just signed with Stetson University. That's a darn good program.
No, he did not. He did not sign. He committed. He verbally committed to Stetson. He's not going pro yet because no one has convinced him to.
Yeah, I know, but what I think...
Peter, there better be a way. You've always been my go-to guy. You can get it done. Now, I've cleared your schedule. Leave today. It's a 3-hour drive. Do not come home until you sign him.
I'm sorry, I can't.
There's confidence! You're saying you can't sign him?
No, I'm saying I can't go out of town. My kid's got his first baseball game.
You're kidding, right?
No, I'm not kidding. Look, Rob, I work really hard, and there's more to life than work.
Really?
Really. Look, Rob, I've seen a lot of young guns burn out real fast in this business. They backstab each other right out of a job. And that's because the only thing they have is their career. Now, I've stayed at the top of my game in this business because my clients know that I value God, my family, and I value them. Rob, there's some things you just don't get back in life. And I'm not missing my kid's ball game.
There are definitely things in life you don't get back. Like your job.
Are you firing me? He's not firing
anybody. Get on out of here. Rob Decker, you and I need to have a talk.
About what?
About Sean Hart. You go sign the kid. Yeah, you. It's been a while since you've been out in the real world. Let's see if you still got it. And you might think about your priorities along the way.
My priorities?
Yes, your priorities. If you just stop long enough to notice, you realize that Peter is right.
Oh, Peter has gotten old and soft.
You are 35 years old, Rob. Take a look around, honey. There's a lot more to life than this.
You know what, Claire? Darling? I think I will go sign this kid myself. Because this is my life. And I don't need more than this.
OnStar, how far is the nearest gas station?
Only one gas station in the immediate area. Bill's gas station, 10 miles ahead.
Great.
Hey! Hey! You fix cars? Ooh! Sorry?
Do you fix cars?
No.
You don't fix cars here?
I can't say that I do.
Well, does he?
No, he definitely don't fix cars, but he plays a mean flat top.
I'm just looking at all the signs. Does anyone here fix cars?
Phil! Drummed up some business for you.
Can you fix my car?
What's wrong with it?
Well, it's smoking.
Let's see. Engine and knees is in the rear.
Don't worry. Once he finds the engine, he could usually fix it.
Can you leave it with me?
It's smoking. I have to leave it with you. Which way to town? Can I rent a car?
You don't need one. You just walk 15 minutes in either direction and well, you're out of town.
Good afternoon. I am Steve. I'm the pastor here at the church.
Rob Decker.
Hey, Rob Decker. Nice to meet you. So, are you lost or hungry?
Well, a little of both, I think. Could smell it a mile away.
Well, you've definitely come to the right place. Welcome to Middletown. This is Small Town USA. We are complete with your hot dogs, your apple pie, and we're known best for our baseball.
Well, that's what I've heard. I also hear you got quite the ball player in Sean Hart.
Oh, yeah. Sean is a great player. But even more, he's a great young man. We're really proud of him here in Middletown. He's heading off to Stetson University. He's going to play for Pete Dunne.
Is that so?
Come on, Sean. Do it again. Come on, Rago. I can't do it again, baby.
Best pitcher of all time, Nolan Ryan.
Not a chance. Greg Maddux, the professor, could put the ball anywhere he wanted.
The Ryan Express threw faster than anyone. 7 no-hitters.
Mad Dog, 4 straight Cy Youngs, 18 gold gloves. Plus, he was cute.
Coffee, Mr. Johnson?
Is it decaf?
This is decaf.
I have to have decaf. I can't take that regular stuff.
I only put decaf in the orange pot.
You know, I went into the city once, and a guy told me, he said, that in the orange pot was hazelnut.
Hazelnut? Well, I don't make hazelnut coffee here, Mr. Johnson. I only put decaf in the orange pot.
I'll take decaf.
All right.
What's good around here?
Fried chicken, potato salad, you name it, it's all good.
Daisy's being modest. The best thing around here are the pies. She makes the best pies around.
We have apple or lemon.
Tough choice.
Well, like I say, when you have a choice like that, take one of each.
Some offers in life you just can't refuse.
Come on, Dragon! No more. You're done. Give the ball to anyone else.
Now I'm ready. My name's Maggie. Can I help you?
Checking in.
What's the name?
Decker. Rob Decker.
And you have a reservation?
Yes.
Could it be under a different name?
No.
And you're sure you called and made a reservation?
No, my assistant did.
You have an assistant? That is quite impressive. Well, it looks like we don't have a reservation under that name.
Just get me a room then.
Say please.
Please.
Oh, I'm so sorry. It looks like we're sold out.
Sold out?
Mm-hmm.
It's not another soul around.
I'm sorry. We don't have any more rooms.
I'm sure my assistant made a reservation. Can I use your phone?
Is it a local call?
No.
Unfortunately, it does not dial long distance.
That is ridiculous. Look, I have to have a room. How about this? How about now?
Oh, this is just too funny. She said you were gonna try to do this.
Who's she? And try what?
Claire, your assistant.
Claire.
And she said that first you're gonna try to bribe me, and also to look out because you might try to throw your phone.
Claire, you talk to Claire.
Mm-hmm. I really like her. She is such a hoot. She helped me plan out this whole scheme when she called and checked you in this morning.
Really?
Uh-huh.
She is such a hoot.
What on earth is that?
That's a high five.
Well, I know what it is. I just didn't think anyone did it anymore. Here. Oh, you don't know. Okay, I'm gonna teach you. One, two, flames. Then you pound it. Explosion! We have to make the sound effects like. It's the Middletown meltdown. Everyone knows it. So I would start practicing.
Where's my room?
If you go right up these stairs, it's the first one on the left.
Thank you. It's quite a town. Quite a town.
See you tomorrow, Mr. Decker.
Oh, I can't wait.
Seriously. Morning, Maggie.
It is, isn't it?
Do you rollerblade?
No.
Where's the high school?
Well, you're really dressed up to be going to high school. Is Kermit going to the prom?
Maggie, I'm going to the high school baseball practice.
Oh. Well, it's just straight down the road that way. Oh, and you're going to want to look for the really big sign that says high school.
Right. Thanks, Maggie.
Oh, and don't forget to practice the handshake. Everyone in town knows it.
Try page 122. 122. Oh, that's it. That's it. I go to table C. Man, there's a lot to these things.
You've got to be kidding me.
That's the one.
John Hart, I'm Rob Decker. I didn't want to bug you at practice, man. Can I steal 5 minutes of your time? I'm a straight shooter, Sean. Da-da-da-da-da! I just want to let you know that I know the best when I see it. You are it. You are the best. Lucky for you, so am I.
You an agent?
Oh, I'm not just any agent. I'm the best of the best. And I only represent the best. You don't know who I am?
No, sir.
Well, you do now. Check out my website, deckersportsgroup.com. We're also on Facebook and Twitter. Got lots of friends and followers. Hey, who's this? What's your name, little man? Okay. So, Sean, I believe this is yours.
Thank you, but I can't take that.
Don't take it. Catch it, man. Oh! Good hands! Big league quick hands. Hands like that, first round draft pick. I'm talking millions of dollars just in a signing bonus.
This isn't mine, sir.
Of course it is. Has your name on it. Possession is 9/10 of the law.
Not in NCAA law. Can't accept gifts from agents. Would make me ineligible. Here, I already told Stetson I'd accept their scholarship offer.
How about you, little man? You committed? Stetson? Woo! You told him, right? On the phone?
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
So you haven't signed your official letter of intent yet?
Same thing.
No, no. Far from the same thing, actually.
Mr. Decker, it was nice to meet you. Me and PJ need to get home.
Okay, sure. I'll catch you guys later. Get some rest. Coach Walker. Rob Decker. Man, it is a pleasure to finally meet you. Sit down, have a talk?
Yeah.
Now, I know a lot of agents came through here, but I want to start fresh. Blank slate. Blank is... as this envelope. As for you, a little something from all of us from Decker Sports Group. You know who we are, right?
Oh, absolutely. Who hadn't heard of Rob Decker and Decker Sports Group?
Apparently, Sean Hart. You do know what I'm talking about, right? You know where I'm coming from and what I want.
Yeah, you want to represent Sean Hart.
That's right. He should not be going to college. He should be going straight to the pros. Can you help me?
I can't take this, man. I love what I do. I love these kids. I don't do it for the money.
Hey, I didn't mean it like you think. I just thought this might help you out, maybe.
Yeah, Rob, I got everything I need, man. Seems to me you might be the one that needs a little help here.
Will you help me?
Look, I mean, I can see both sides. Coached the kid for 4 years. I know he can do it all. Personally, I don't think you got a shot. But if you want to go for it, he lives right down the road at Cook Boys Ranch. I suggest you talk to Miss Cook first.
Thanks, Coach.
You got it.
Excuse me. Is this the Cook Boys Ranch?
This is it.
Oh. Hi.
Hello.
Daisy, right?
That's right.
Rob Decker. We met at the Spring Festival.
Yes, we did. Can I help you?
Yes. I'm looking for someone. Sean Hart. You one of the boys here at the ranch?
Sean lives here.
Great. Could you tell me where I could find Miss Cook?
Well, that would be me.
You? Oh, wow. It's my lucky day.
Well, I'm flattered, Mr. Decker, but you might not want to get too excited. I might not be telling you what you want to hear.
Oh, I don't know about that. Pretty easy to please.
Is that a fact?
Yes, ma'am. How do you know what I want to hear anyway?
Everyone knows why you're in town.
Well, hear me out before you shut me down. Can you do that for me? I'm just a poor, dumb city boy. Trying to survive in this cold, cold world.
Just a lost boy with a Benz? This is gonna be good.
I like your style, Daisy. I'm here to do what I do best. I'm an agent. The best sports agent. According to some. Most, actually. I'm here to bring good news. To bring riches. Do you realize what a $5 million signing bonus is? What could be done right here with his instant wealth? The boys could have iPhones, iPads, iTouches.
Wow. You're kind of like Superman.
Come on.
Here to save the day.
I'm just here to make sure you consider all the options.
I think we have. Sean has a lot of gifts. Beyond baseball. Do you know that he's got a 4.0 GPA? He's the senior class president. He writes incredible poetry. He even competed in a state math competition. You know, baseball will end someday. But a college education? That'll be with him for the rest of his life.
Poetry. Really?
Yeah.
Hey, I know. It's a tough choice.
Life is all about choices, Rob. Sean's thought this decision through thoroughly. He's researched it. He's asked the right people the right questions. And this might not mean much to you, but he's prayed about it a lot. Do you ever pray, Mr. Decker?
I can do that, yes. And I will. But first, I just want to make
sure... Mr. Decker, when you're in a hole...
Yeah, I know. Stop digging.
No. Look up. And pray. And Mr. Decker, try and let God do some of the talking.
I feel like you might have won round one. But I still got a little gas left in the tank.
Oh, how ironic. For a man without a car.
Ooh.
Mm. Joey! It's a tradition.
What does it mean?
I'm not sure right now is the right time, but this is a big deal.
Okay. I'll talk to you another time.
Mr. Decker.
Hi, Maggie.
Well, you haven't given up, have you?
Huh?
You know, the handshake. Flames. Good job. You almost have it. Very impressive.
Thank you, Maggie. Is that mink?
Pink. Good night.
Claire, it's me. Any calls?
Yeah, but I've got everything covered till you get back from your mission. What's it like there?
Well, it's kind of like Mayberry, except Andy's a professor and Goober and Gomer are Mac and Phil.
Well, how's the hunt for Mr. October?
Very funny.
You sign him yet?
Claire, this is a tough one.
Come on. You've seen it all.
There is something going on here that I have never had to deal with before. And Claire, they asked me to pray.
You should pray. Thank you, Lord. They sound like my kind of people.
Good morning, Mr. Decker.
Yes, it is.
Well, let's see it. Wow, you got it.
Was there ever a doubt?
I think you're ready to try it on your own.
You know, I can see you, Fess. You're reflected in his eyeglasses.
Willie, you've been watching way too much Texas Hold'em.
Your move, Phil Ivey. Let's see. 16 down.
How many letters?
Five.
Five letters.
Across or down?
Are you going to help me now?
Across or down?
Down, and it ends in Y.
Hello there.
Hello there, Beck. I need a haircut.
We can do that right here.
Trim. Clean it up.
Neck right around the ears. Take up the sideburns an eighth of an inch. Just an eighth.
You got
it? I get a trim every Tuesday and Friday.
Oh.
Nice.
Maybe you ought to take a trim to that car of yours.
How do you know about my car?
It's a small town. You know, the word travels fast, and a lot faster than your car.
How is my car coming, Fess?
Phil and Mac are making some progress. How about yourself?
Oh, I'm making progress. I went out to the boys' ranch, talked with Daisy.
Now that Daisy, she's pretty protective of those boys out there. You're lucky you came back with your skin on.
She was actually cordial.
I'll tell you what, man, Boys Ranch is a special place. Cooks out there give them boys hope, and man, that's something they don't get a lot of, especially Sean.
Hey, have you ever seen Sean play in a game? In person, or is tonight going to be your first time?
What's tonight?
Tonight, the alumni game. The whole town is going to be there.
Will Daisy be there?
Oh, yeah, she'll be there.
Well, then I'll be there, too.
Well, you're either very brave or very stupid.
He is no fool.
Hey, Rob.
What's that about?
Well, you know us preachers. We're always looking for the catchy phrase to get people's attention. But actually, this comes from a quote from a guy named Jim Elliot. He was a missionary back in the 1950s. He went with four other guys to the remote jungles of Ecuador to try to take the message of God's love to very dangerous tribe of natives. All of his friends, of course, thought he was crazy for going to such a dangerous place. He was a young guy, bright, had a great future ahead of him. In fact, he was a great athlete, as a matter of fact. As the story unfolds, he and the four missionaries with him were, in fact, all attacked and killed by the very people that they were trying to help. So it looked like a pretty tragic end to that story. But then, amazing and pretty miraculous things started to happen as a result of those five men's deaths. Many of the people in that tribe actually became believers and followers of God, and some of the very men that killed those missionaries became missionaries themselves, if you can believe that. And the whole tribe really became a very peaceful and kind people.
So how do they explain that?
Well, that's a great question. Even the anthropologist that had studied this tribe for years Couldn't believe it, couldn't explain it. So anyway, after he died, this quote was found in Jim Elliot's journals where he had written these words, "He is no fool who gives what he cannot keep to gain that which he cannot lose." So, he is no fool.
Well, I guess there's more than one way to define foolishness.
I actually have been feeling a little foolish ever since I got to town.
You know, you and everyone else knows why I'm here. But I'm actually not a bad guy. I feel I really do know what's best for Sean. But I'm getting nowhere. I guess I just need to spend some more time with Daisy and get close to Sean.
Well, Mr. Decker, I don't think you're a bad guy at all. And in fact, I think it'd be a great idea for you to spend some time with Daisy and with the boys. And here's an idea. You should go to the game tonight. Everybody's going to be there. And you need to come to the concert tomorrow night.
What concert?
Oh, yeah. Big concert going on at the Athens Theater. Very cool band. I think you might like it. And I bet you Daisy and the guys will be there also.
Okay. Pastor, thank you so much.
All right, Rob. See you, bud.
Over. Can I sit here?
Looks like you are sitting here.
Hey, mister, you want to buy a raffle ticket?
No, thanks.
Come on.
How much?
$1. You can win a pie.
A pie?
2 pies.
You're kidding, right?
Do I look like I'm kidding?
Last chance to buy tickets for tonight's raffle. The winning ticket takes home 2 pies from the kitchen of Daisy Cook.
Whoa, 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 kid. How many you got there?
I don't know, about 50?
50. Give me all of them.
And that's strikeout number 6 for our alumni team, Hometown Hero.
This is unbelievable.
Well, you can't stop him. Just try to contain him.
Hey, officer, how fast was that?
92 mile an hour curveball.
Who is this guy? He's throwing BBs.
This guy's really in a slump. He hasn't had a hit in 3 weeks. Let's give him one.
All right, squad. Tell him I'm gonna groove this one right down the middle.
Let's do it.
Here we go, boys.
Right. Come on.
Clean level, big fella. Coming right down the middle for you.
Thank you.
Scooter.
Scooter? That's his name?
Yeah, Scooter.
Well, does he have a last name?
And here are the winning numbers for tonight's raffle. Winner gets 2 homemade pies. And the winning ticket is 91213.
Hey, check your ticket.
Who has ticket 91213?
Ah, that's me.
We do have a winner here. This is your lucky night.
Ooh, you have no idea. Claire?
Hello, Rob.
Listen to me. Drop everything.
Drop everything for what?
I need you to call some of my guys and tell them I might need a favor.
What kind of a favor?
It's just a hunch.
What is going on out there?
If I told you, you wouldn't believe it.
Well, I can call the big three.
I'll call you tomorrow and I'll tell you possibly when and where.
Is this Steve Wales, general manager of the best team in baseball?
Rob Decker.
Get off the
treadmill, my friend, because you're going to need to sit down for this one. You're going to feel like it's Christmas morning when this one's done.
Rob, I'm working here.
Stevie.
Look, I want to let you know I called you first. But I'm not going to lie. As soon as I hang up, I'm calling the rest of the league.
Now, what do you need more than anything else?
Pitching, right? An ace? Who doesn't, especially you? And not just a number one starter. I'm talking
a strikeout pitcher.
Yeah, what am I going to have to give up?
Nothing.
It's not a trade. Free agent.
Is he in the league?
Unsigned. An unsigned gold mine.
Look,
if it's that kid from Cuba, I've already seen him.
He's American.
And you haven't seen him, I guarantee it. Because if you did, he'd be playing for you.
Where'd he play his college ball?
He didn't.
What, is he in jail?
Steve, trust me, you'll want him. His fastball jumps like the wind. His curveball,
falls off a table.
So what do you want? How much is it going to cost me?
I want you to work him out, a tryout.
Okay, bring him to California.
How soon?
Let's make it the middle of the week.
We're looking at a catcher from Jersey. They can work out together. Can you get him here by then?
I'm Rob Decker. I can do anything. And Steve, I guarantee you'll make him an offer before he hits the showers.
Rob Decker?
Have you even signed this guy yet?
Steve, come on. That's the easy part. All in a day's work.
Fellas, this looks like a good sign. Guessing my car's done?
Nope. But we're making progress.
Okay.
Hey, were you at the alumni game last night?
No. We were here, working on your car.
What's the dog's name?
Pedro.
Pedro. Okay. I'll check back later. Fellas.
Okay.
What you need, another eighth inch cut over there?
That's good. There you go.
I am talking miles, miles per hour. Okay. So tell me about Scooter. What's the deal?
What do you want to know?
What do I want to know? I want to know everything. Where does he live? What's he do? How old is he? And that can't be his real name. How does someone get a name like Scooter?
What do you think he can throw? You ought to see him run.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Wow! So what's his real name?
Danny. Danny Cook.
Danny Cook. That's Danny Cook. The Danny Cook.
Mm-hmm.
Man, we were hearing about him when he was 16. And then he just disappeared. That had to be about 10 years ago. You know where I can find him?
Not a half day, Mr. Decker!
Just getting started.
Thank you.
Maggie, what are you doing?
Practicing going to the beach.
You're wearing pants.
And?
You're amazing, Maggie.
Good game last night. It's kind of like our first date.
Oh, I wish I would have known. Could have at least bought a girl a hot dog.
Oh.
I see you're still on foot. Taking this what would Jesus do thing seriously?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Get it? He walked everywhere?
Oh.
Yeah.
That's you being funny.
Oh. Ouch.
It is amazing how much thinking you can do while you're walking. I'm starting to notice things all around this little town I might have missed otherwise.
Wow. Big city sports agent being wooed by our little town. Now I've seen everything. Thinking of giving up the Benz for good?
Oh, I have no idea what's going on with my car. Phil and Mac.
Oh, Phil and Mac, they can fix anything. Well, Phil can.
But if you say Phil can get it done, that's good to know. I do need to get back at some point. Can't stay here forever.
Would that be so bad?
I'm just a fast-paced guy. I love the excitement of the big city. Energy, the bright lights. But I do admit, there are some things I've become quite fond of here.
Heads up!
Whoa, hey! Speaking of baseball...
Never seen anything like last night. That pitcher for the alumni team, Scooter. Interesting. I'll be honest. Did some homework this morning at the barbershop, which is the hub of all local information.
Yes.
They told me Scooter's real name is Danny Cook, and he lives here in Cook Ranch. You're Daisy Cook. I said Daisy Cook, Danny Cook. Obviously, they're married.
Oh.
Boys got quite a chuckle out of that. And then let me know otherwise.
Well, Mr. Obvious, Scooter's my brother. It's a good thing you're an agent and not a detective.
Your brother's really good. He might actually be the best I've ever seen.
And I bet you want to talk to him, don't you?
You okay with that?
Absolutely. In fact, take as much time as you like. I'm gonna enjoy this.
Yeah.
Scooter. This is Mr. Decker. He thinks you're the best ever.
Please, call me Rob. Nice. See, someone's met Maggie.
Well?
Not bad, Rob. Hey, y'all run along. I'm gonna talk to Mr. Decker real quick, all right?
Please allow me to formally introduce myself. I am Rob Decker. I'm from Decker Sports Group. We represent the top athletes in all professional sports. Now, of course, I'm proud to say this because the agency is actually mine. I founded it, I'm president, and I'm CEO.
Congrats on that. Yeah, word spreads pretty fast in this town. Heard you're looking for Sean, right?
Yes, that's right. I came here to sign Sean Hart.
Now, he's going to college. Stetson.
I heard he was interested in college.
Actually, he wants to be a doctor. Imagine that?
He's a great shortstop.
He's even a better kid.
I'll be honest. I think he's a first-round draft pick right out of high school. Millions of dollars just in a signing bonus.
Now, I know you don't think you're the first agent that's come around here offering
big money, right?
No, no, of course not. But I just want to point out.
Listen, Mr. Decker. Look, I just want to save you some time. I know the sound of a huge signing bonus and nice car, big house. Now, that's going to turn the head of any young teenage American boy. But that is not Sean. And he knows God's got a path for him. Now, maybe that path is paved in dollar bills or not, I don't know. But he knows where it leads. God knows where Sean's going. And with all due respect, Mr. Decker, I don't think you know where that boy's been.
Okay. What do I need to know?
A young man you're looking at?
Not the same boy that showed up here. He was 10 years old. Harder than any kid ought to be at that age. He was angry, broken. Dad left him the day he was born. His mom had her troubles. Yeah, he probably doesn't have a memory of her coming around sober. So by the time she was killed in that car wreck, the kid was far too used to having to take care of himself.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, he hated those words. Tired of hearing I'm sorry for this and that. Couldn't hardly say him himself. I'm sad to see a kid like that. So, we just had to let him know he was loved and valuable. Taught him to trust in God as a good father. That wasn't an easy road. So, when he rang that bell, that was something.
So the tradition of the bell is what? It's accepting God?
Yeah, well, it's kind of our tradition, you know, but it's more than that. It's about accepting that God has accepted you. So yeah. Yeah, Sean discovered baseball here real quick. God smiled on him with that, as you can tell. Now baseball is going to give him an opportunity to reach far beyond that outfield fence. He's going to get a good education. Mr. Decker, he's going to make a real difference in people's lives. I'm asking you, Mr. Decker, move on. Don't interfere with Sean's decision.
I can't believe I'm saying this. I think you're right.
Baseball, huh? What a game.
It's a great game.
Who'd you watch growing up?
Man, I used to love the Cubbies. But I will say my favorite team of all time, 93 Phillies when they went to the World Series. Misfits.
Who you like today?
I like Tim Tebow.
Well, he doesn't play baseball.
Could if you wanted to.
Oh. Can we talk about Danny Cook? How'd you get the name Scooter?
Earned it, of course. My dad gave it to me. Stole just about every base from here to the Dominican.
Ooh, so you're a worldwide Scooter?
No, it's not like that. My parents were missionaries. Traveled all over, mostly third world countries, spreading the gospel. I grew up stealing bases. And watching my parents live out that gospel.
You were on everyone's radar. And then you just disappeared.
That all depends on whose radar. See, I played all through the mission fields. Thing is, Mr. Decker, you could throw a ball 100 miles an hour. You're gonna get people's attention when you bring them something more powerful than that.
Did you ever think of the platform you could have standing on the mound in Yankee Stadium?
Of course. All the time, I still do. All I have to do though is look out there. See Joey, Sean, PJ, Little Red. Those guys know I didn't disappear. I saw you here the other day. Heard Joey ring that bell. He made the most important decision of his life. Right here in my own backyard. Mr. Decker. This is my Yankee Stadium. Look at PJ. Right beside Sean every step of the way.
Little Red?
This is his last stop after six failed foster homes. Six. He don't want to leave. They all came here with a lot of hurt. There's still plenty of that to go around. What we can give them is a lifetime of love and prayer. There's hope, Mr. Decker. They find it right here. And that, my friend, is a hope they can take with them the rest of their lives. We don't pretend we can fix them. Just want them to know they've got a good father. It's a father who's never gonna leave them.
Never forsake them. Father who's never going to forget him.
Jesus Christ. It's the father to the fatherless.
I told you Sean Hart's off the table. I'm not going to say the same thing about you. I would love to see what you could do against some of the greats.
Not unless they show up in my backyard. You let me know how that goes for you, all right?
I'm sorry, there's no time to call. We didn't know what else to do. We were just sent to pick him up, and his mom was in a car accident. And there's no father, no siblings. We're trying to figure out if there's any extended family.
What's he been told?
All he knows is that there's been an accident.
What's his name?
Jason. He's 14.
Hey, Jason. I'm Scooter. You hungry? Come on, let's go inside.
I think I got a cheeseburger with your name written all over it.
We'll take it from here. All right, I'll call you later.
Anything I can do?
Cast and Crown's concert is tonight, and Scooter and I are not gonna be able to leave. The boys were looking so forward to it. It's probably best if they're not here right now. Is there any way you could take them?
Yeah, of course.
Right. The boys be good. Thank you. Good night.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Leave it all behind. Leave it all behind. Leave it all behind.
Yeah, guys are good. So I want you guys to know that before you got here tonight, all the tour, all the bands, all the crew, we all gathered in here and we walked through these chairs praying for you before you got here, praying that this would be more than just another Christian family fun night. Because some of you know as good as I do, you know, a song might change your afternoon, but it's not going to change your life. It's going to take something way more than feeling good and feeling better to change your lives. I can't live by what I feel, but I live by the truth God's word reveals. And when I stand before God one day, he's not going to ask me how I felt. He's not going to ask me what church I went to. He's not going to ask me how many good things I do and how many bad things I stopped doing. What he's going to ask me is, what did I do with Jesus? Because we're all in the same boat down here. No one's here any more of a train wreck than the guy standing up here with a microphone right now. We're lost, we're broken, we're fallen, and we can't fix ourselves. So don't come to a concert and hear this and then think, I need to go get good and come back to God, because you can't. It's way too late to get good, yeah? I've got to realize I'm broken and I'm fallen and I need Jesus. And God says in his word that if we confess with our mouths that Jesus is Lord and believe in our heart God raised him from the dead, we'll be saved. Listen, confess with my mouth that Jesus is Lord. Lord is not a nickname for Jesus. Lord means king. To be his is to confess with my mouth that Jesus is the Lord and King of my life forever. And I will follow my King forever. And I believe in my heart that the same God that raised Jesus from the dead can raise me from the dead. That's so much bigger than trying to be better. It's realizing, Lord, I need you. I'm desperate and I lay my life at your feet. I turn from the sin in my life and I'm following you to be yours. That's good stuff. You can do that tonight. If you feel like you're still on the outside looking in when it comes to a friendship with God, Jesus himself said, no one comes to the Father unless the Spirit draws him. So if it's even on your mind and in your heart right now to take a step towards the Father, please know, this is very personal. He's not waving his hand over a crowd right now. He's calling you right now. And you can lay your life at his feet tonight. Can we just pray together? Just bow our heads and close our eyes. There's nothing magical about it. We're just getting our mind off everybody else and asking God to show us truth for us. Father, if anyone in here needs you, they already know it. You've been moving in their lives long before they got to this room. So now that we're here, it would be a tragedy to come this close to the well and go home thirsty. Lord, if anyone needs you, let them lay their life at your feet now. Draw them to you. Guys, if you're here and you want to know Jesus, just tell them. Say, Lord, I'm yours. Take my sin, take my junk, take all the garbage. I lay it at your feet and I follow you. If you're here tonight and that is what your heart is crying out, I want to pray with you. There's some pastors in the area that have been praying for this event long before you got here. And they'd love to meet you down here in the front and just pray with you before you go. Because as cool as this moment is in here, life isn't like this, all quiet and tidy while we get our thoughts together. We got to leave this building and know how to live. And we need to walk with Jesus in a church that will love us. I'll meet you right down here. As the pastors come forward, you come down. Meet us down here and let us pray with you guys. You come. Someone to come with you, you bring them with you. Just come down here with us. Father God, thank you for being so real to us. Thank you, God, that you didn't need any of this to go on to talk to us. But Lord, you've used this moment to draw some brand new brothers and sisters to you. I thank you for what you're doing. God, I thank you that you are the reformer and the reshaper, the transformer of our lives. And we love you and we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Great news. His mom's gonna be okay, and they located his uncle in the next town over.
That is good news.
Thank you so much. Come on, let's go.
I told Daisy I would pray. God, I know you're up there. I know you're real. Because I've seen you. Seen you here. In this place. Thank you for letting me see this.
Hi, Mom. No, I'm fine. Everything's okay. I will. I just called to say hi. No, I'm not laughing at you. I will. Yeah, I know. I know you're praying for me. That's what moms do. I will. I love you too, Mom. Thank you.
This is Rob.
Rob, where are you?
What?
The guys are waiting for you.
What time is it?
It's 10 o'clock in the morning. Did you just wake up?
Megan, I need to borrow your bike.
That's not a good idea. No, really, Mr. Decker, that is not a good idea. Bring it back, Mr. Decker. No! Stop that! No, 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 come back, come back, come back!
Thanks, Maggie!
It doesn't have any brakes!
Kidding?
This isn't gonna end good.
Oh. That is brutal.
Rob, are you kidding me?
You're all right, bud?
What?
Rob, look who showed up in my backyard. Mr. Cy Young over here, Rick Sutcliffe. Remember the 93 Phillies team I was telling you about? It's John Kruk. Mr. All-Star over here, Ben Zobrist.
Man, the performance was great, but the dismount and landing was terrible. Crucky, what do you think about that?
A couple things. For the bike, first of all, are you kidding me? Did you sleep in the clothes? And you're an agent, Sut. You wonder why our careers are in the toilet right now. That's what represents us.
Yeah, you can all laugh. You can all laugh.
If you're going to eat, you better eat quick, because I'm here to see some of that Florida heat I've been hearing about.
Go get him, Scooter.
All right.
Sut, it's on.
Oh, not me. I'm the pitcher. Obviously, he's not going anywhere. Go get him, Big Ben. It's all up to you, buddy.
I'd love to. All right, batter up.
Go, Ben.
How you doing, catch?
All right.
We're gonna die.
You want to take a few first?
I'm good.
Wow, okay.
I love it.
That's not good.
Oh.
Huh. You kidding me?
Yeah, you might need that, man.
I'm gonna take you up on that one.
A little practice.
Heads up.
There it is.
Oh, my.
There it is. That was pretty good.
You better you than me.
What did I tell you guys? What did I tell you guys?
Oh. Uncle Charlie is in the house.
You didn't swing and miss that much last year.
All right, I got this. Time to get serious, fellas.
I am so glad I'm old. What's he doing out here in this pasture? Take this stuff to the show.
I'm trying my best. All right, you guys are going to want to step behind the screen for this one.
Oh. Wait.
Okay.
I got you, buddy.
The cockiness.
All right.
I think somebody's a little upset.
Tell you what, this all started out as nice fun and games. This is serious stuff right now, son.
Come on, Ben.
Show them where you live, baby.
Ooh!
And the mighty Casey has struck out.
Game over.
All right, boys, this is it. Bottom of the ninth, two outs, full count, bases loaded, and you know you're down by three.
I got him.
With Crookie hitting behind you, you better go deeper. This one's over.
Woo! Yeah! Yeah! All right. Yeah,
What just happened?
It's a tradition. When someone accepts Jesus into their heart, they get to ring the bell.
Really? I have Jesus in my heart, and I never got to ring the bell.
Well, get up there. Come on.
Okay.
Guys, make some room.
Ben, thank you so much for coming out, man. I really appreciate it.
Rob, thanks for bringing us out here.
Yeah, you're welcome.
You know, I really think you found something here.
Yeah. Thanks, Ben. Fellas, thanks for coming.
Don't ruin his career. He's got some future.
I love the confidence, man. Sut, thank you so much for coming out.
Had a great time. Good luck.
Thank you, guys.
See you, Rob.
See you later, Rob. See you guys.
And all who thirst will thirst no more. And all who search will find what their souls long for. The world will try, but it can never fail. So leave it all behind and come to the well.
You're amazing. I mean it.
Thank you.
You could have a real audience.
I do have a real audience. Rob, your head's down and you're so focused, but you can miss a lot that way. Sometimes what you're looking for isn't what you're looking for.
Just admit I was right, please.
About what?
About Scooter. He is that good. I'm not crazy.
You saw it. You heard them. You have to admit, he'd be an unbelievable pitcher in the bigs.
He'd be more than unbelievable. He'd make the Hall of Fame.
What did you say?
Scooter would be the best. Best ever, maybe.
Wow.
I never thought you'd ever...
Why would me saying that surprise you? I know my baseball. If I managed the Yankees, he'd be my Rivera. He's got a fastball most people haven't seen since...
Since never?
God gives people incredible gifts. Some more than one. Maybe they have to choose. For Scooter and I, that choice felt more like a calling. Scooter's only 17, he had his whole life ahead of him. But we grew up watching my parents help people. Whoever, wherever, all the time. My parents were missionaries, even here. This place was their dream.
I didn't know that.
You couldn't have known. Just like Scooter and I couldn't have known how one moment, one phone call, would change our lives forever. In an instant, we went from helping orphans to being orphans. My parents died in a plane crash, and what could have destroyed our hope in God only taught us to trust in Him more.
I wouldn't have known what to do.
We didn't either. But we learned. We had to. This place felt like our calling, our home, John's home. And that bell. hear that bell ring and to know what that sound represents, to hear what just happened to a heart, to know something that that person can't keep to themselves, I don't think I can ask for anything more.
This place. This place is amazing. How do you even get by?
By faith. We walk by faith and we pray a lot. We pray and we share whatever God provides. And he does provide. The people in this town, they really come through for us. They support us. And you know, you can't be around these boys and not be inspired.
Well, that inspiration comes from watching you and Scooter.
And our inspiration comes from God.
Maybe that's what it is. That concert last night. I felt something there that I've never felt before. Like I didn't want to stay where I was. Or how I was.
You don't have to. That's God, Rob. He's at the door of your heart. All you have to do is open the door and invite him in.
I wish. I wish it was that easy. I've got a lot of stuff.
We've all got stuff, Rob. God knows we've got stuff. That's why Jesus came. To free us from all that. Don't hold on to the stuff. Lay it down.
I don't want to. I want what you have. But
that is what I have, though, Rob. Beautiful, undeserved grace. Forgiveness. It's yours too. Whatever your stuff, it's yours too. All you have to do is invite him in and ask him for forgiveness.
Asking anyone for anything. It's not who I am.
That is who he is. You're gonna have to do the asking this time. You know, there's strength that comes from asking for help. Accept his gift of grace. Invite him in. His hand is outstretched. All you have to do is reach out and take it. Looks like your car's ready.
Here she is, good as new.
What do I owe?
Oh, a lady named Claire called and took care of everything.
Well, thank you.
guess this is it. First time I didn't get my man.
Do you mean Sean or Scooter?
Both. I'm okay with that. Well, I can hear the big city calling.
Decker.
Goodbye, Daisy.
Do you ever pray, Mr. Decker?
This walk is hard, I feel the weight is wearing down. And I can't do this on my own. But in this darkness, I can see your light is shining down. Now I know which way is home.
Look up and pray.
Oh.
standing in the shadow of something that's impossible for you. Have you taken time to consider all the great things that God's about to do? If you just cast your fears aside and trust the one who holds your life, all you got is all you need. You got what it takes, so just believe. It don't take much, it's the faith of a mustard seed. That's all you got, that's all you need. Yeah. Looking back behind you at the mountain, you once said there's no way you could fly. Well, they're gone now, oh, they're history. That miracle can happen one more time. If you just cast your fears aside and trust the one who holds your life, all you got is all you need. You've got what it takes, so just believe. It don't take much, just the faith of a mustard seed. That's all you got, that's all you need. Just cast your fears aside and trust the one who holds your life. He holds your life. All you got is all you need. You got what it takes to just believe. It don't take